Hey, this is Ray Dombrowski. Today I want to talk about how graphic designers set up their t-shirt graphics to look vintage. And the thing that makes t-shirt graphics look vintage is actually the properties of the ink that's used to print them. And an ink that's been used since the 70s and 80s is called plastisol. And over time it gets dried out and it just cracks and flakes, and that's how you get that vintage look. So I've got a collection of textures that I made from thrift store t-shirt graphics, and they're all in nice Bitmap Tiff, Photoshop PSD, and Photoshop brush format. So first I'll show you the Bitmap Tiff files, and these are the best way to use textures in Illustrator. Vector textures, especially big ones with a lot of vector points, can get very cumbersome, hard to deal with. That's why Bitmap Tiffs are so awesome. So I'll go ahead and show you one. And to use it, all you need to do is go File, Place, and then just pick one of the 30 textures. And I'll just pick this one. It's sort of a medium texture. So let me size this thing up. And when you're adding these textures to your graphic, typically you want the texture color to match the background color. And the reason is simply when you have a t-shirt and areas of ink get cracked or flaked off, what you see is a t-shirt fabric below. And this is exactly how I would set up a file for screen printing. So I could send this off to a screen printer right now. Let me show you another one. And here I've got a super vectory looking surfer, very glossy looking brand new graphic. And I'll just go File, Place, and I'll place another one of these right on top, and you'll notice how it defaults to a black color when you first place it in. And all you need to do is have your texture selected and then grab your little eyedropper tool and select the background color, and now you've got a texture. The other thing you'll notice about bitmap textures, if you haven't used them in Illustrator before, on the screen, they're kind of displayed sort of pixely, but when you output them, say for web, or you print it out on your Epson printer, or you send it off to a screen printer, these textures actually look nice and smooth. And in this case, I can show you File, Save for Web. And let me zoom in here at 200%. And depending on the resolution of the video you're watching right now, you may or may not be able to see this, but all of a sudden we have a nice textured vintage graphic. It's not so vectory and brand new looking, which is exactly what we're going for. So that's Illustrator. Let me show you a Photoshop file. This is an old Ford Bronco I took a picture of in Hawaii. And I've got it transparent on a tan background. And the best way to use these textures in Photoshop is to actually use the Photoshop brushes. And these are super easy to load. Let me just open this. This is the folder you'll get when you download. Here's the bitmaps. Here's the Photoshop brushes. And it also comes with flattened PSDs if you really want to go into these files and kind of play with the levels, but you know, that's for more advanced users or people with a lot of time on their hands. If you're looking to do this real quick, if you're working on a fairly medium to almost high resolution file, you can get by with the 1500 pixel brushes. If you're using a really high resolution graphic, you should use the 3000 pixel brushes. In this example, it's actually fairly low res, so I'll use the 1500 pixel brushes. You just double click on it. It's automatically loaded into your brushes palette. And before I show you that, let me show you how I add texture to a graphic without messing anything up. And it's also a good method to use if you tend to go back to your files and change the colors or alter things. So the way I'm going to add a texture to this file is with a layer mask. And I want to do that to the Bronco layer. So I have that Bronco selected, and I go Layer, layer mask, reveal all, and that adds sort of a channel to it, and it's selected right now. And what I want to do is go to my Photoshop brushes, and these are the 30 brushes that I just loaded from the Plastisol textures collection. And I'll just select one of these. Let me try this one. And you'll see my cursor is now a giant brush, basically. It's a giant Plastisol brush. And with your bracket keys, you can size this up or size it down. And basically, all you're doing is you're painting black into this layer mask. And that's going to create transparency on your Bronco. So I'll just click in there and voila, there's your Bronco with texture. So the nice thing about using layer masks with these textures is it doesn't mess anything up. You're not locked in anything. You can go back and change the color. I'll change the background here just to show you the transparency that comes through. So image, adjustments, hue saturation. And let's just change this to like a yellow. And you can see that the yellow comes right through the Bronco now. So that's it. These things are super easy to use. Again, with Illustrator, you want to use Bitmap Tiffs. With Photoshop in general, the Photoshop brushes are the easiest and most versatile. I've got high resolution images of these if you want to see them. And there's also a link below the video. Follow that to find out more about the Plastisol Textures Collection. Thanks for watching.